Question number one this week comes from Eddie Rios. And Eddie says, greetings, my friend. Love your podcast. I listen to every episode you produce, usually in my car on my way home from work. Keep up the good work. Thank you, brother. I appreciate that. With the announcement of the Obi-Wan series, do you think we'll see a young Luke Skywalker on Tatooine? It's good to know you are slowly building more followers. You deserve it. Peace. Thank you, brother. Thank you for the question. And for those of you that don't know, there, I mean, I don't know who wouldn't know at this point unless you've been living on a rock at Black Spire Outpost. There's an Obi-Wan series coming on Disney Plus, and it's the talk of the Star Wars community, apparently. Right now, I'm kind of focused more on The Mandalorian, but we'll talk about some Obi-Wan for a little while. Yes. To answer your question, yes. I do think we're going to see a young Luke Skywalker in this series. And the reason is, anytime we've seen Obi-Wan on Tatooine, well, we've really only seen one good scene of Obi-Wan on Tatooine between episodes 3 and 4, and that is Rebels, where, you know, Ezra comes and finds Obi-Wan and, you know, the whole Darth Maul thing happens. The conversation between Obi-Wan and Maul about Obi-Wan trying to protect someone really drives the point home that Obi-Wan is there for Luke, which we all knew he was in the first place. But that's the sole reason Obi-Wan is on that planet. I shouldn't say the sole reason. The main reason he's on Tatooine. The other reason is he's in hiding so that Vader and the Emperor can't find him. And Vader doesn't like sand, so Tatooine's going to be the last place he looks. So, yes, I do believe if we're going to start this Obi-Wan series, let's say, you know, 10 years after Revenge of the Sith, and Luke Skywalker is 10 years old, we have to establish that context. We have to establish the setting of the series so far, why Obi-Wan is on this planet. Because you have to make these series in a way where if all you've ever seen was 1, 2, and 3, and you're going through it chronologically, you have to, or maybe you've never seen it. Maybe Obi-Wan is the first thing of Star Wars you've ever seen. You have to establish to some people why Obi-Wan is on Tatooine and what his purpose there is and why he's there and what led up to it and, you know, what he's dealing with on the planet. And with Luke Skywalker being the main reason that he's on Tatooine, that has got to be brought front and center in the Obi-Wan series. First episode. It has to be brought in first episode. Because, I mean, most people, if let's say somebody's sitting down and watching Star Wars chronologically for the first time. Let's say they sit down with the Star Wars Canon Podcast's timeline, right? And they go, okay, we're going to go, we're going to read this book, watch this movie, book, movie, movie, series, book, movie, series, comic, right? And then you get to Disney Plus, Obi-Wan series. And they have no idea what comes later on. They know at that point that's why Obi-Wan is there. And just look at the way the Mandalorian's being shot. Look at some of the techniques that they're using to make the Mandalorian. Look at how the Mandalorian is feeling so far with the trailer. They are making the Mandalorian a love letter to the fans. You know, I mean, heavy practical effects. I mean, even model shots and camera passes and whatnot. It's a love letter to the fans. Fans will lose their collective shit if a 10-year-old Luke Skywalker pops up in the Obi-Wan series. And in a good way. In a way that I think a lot of fans need to lose their shit. Instead of, oh, hey, you know, screw Rian Johnson. And all, just, whatever. This is, you got to focus on the positive. That is a positive. So I absolutely, balls to bone, believe we are going to see a young Luke Skywalker in the Obi-Wan series. Maybe Luke would even be a main part of the story. I don't know. And some of the comics that we've seen of Obi-Wan on Tatooine, he's watching over Luke. That's the main purpose of him being there. That's really what you see. He directly saves Luke in one of them. And why wouldn't Luke be in that series? You know, he might even be pivotal to the series. Who knows? Maybe Luke gets kidnapped or something. You know, and Obi-Wan has to go off and find him. I don't know. I'm not writing it. The scripts are written, but I don't know. So, to answer your question, yes, I do believe Luke is going to pop up in the series. They'd be stupid not to at this point. So, let me know, guys, in the comments below. I want to see what your guys' thoughts are. Do you think Luke's going to pop up? Maybe not. Let me know. I want to hear your guys' thoughts. Thanks for the question, Eddie. I do appreciate it.